Have you ever been so excited about something that you can't bring yourself to actually do it or open it or whatever the case may be? That's kind of how I feel about these two packages right here. So I've been doing junk journals for the past 3 years, I believe, and I have two favorite artists, people who I look up to so much, and it seems like, reaching for the moon or something to try to create something as beautiful as what these two ladies create. And those are, of course, Barbara from 49 Dragonflies and Louisa Heinzel from Louisa Heinzel Junk Journal Art. For a long time, I've been wanting to own physical items made by each of these ladies, and recently I've had the opportunity to make purchases from both of their shops since Barbara started selling physical items. And so these items that I have, they're not huge, chunky journals because, those are going to be out of my budget, but we have items made by my two favorite artists in the world. So we're going to unbox these today, and I hope that I don't cry. So we'll start with this one. This one is from Barbara, and it's packaged up very nicely. Let's see if I can get into it. Okay. Oh my goodness. This is so cute. I think this is from one of her recent digital kits. Oh. I'm trying to be so careful, like, I just don't want to, like, ruin anything. Okay, so this is an ephemera storage holder. And it's in German. It's an old German children's book. I don't know what this means. I think this is the, and then children. I'm not sure what this word means. Might have to do some Google translating, see if I can figure that out. By Hilda Forster. This is just a beautiful book cover, and she's done a spiral binding on it, and then there's inside it is an ephemera holder. Aw. Okay, so there's this cute card here that says, "Thank you for supporting my small business." And there's a note here. This is from Vienna. "Dear Bobby, thank you so much for your order. I hope this ephemera book brings you as much joy as mine brings me. Sending hugs, Barbara." And then there's her logo and her little business card. So I will provide links for both of these ladies down below. Not that they need referrals from me, but just in case any of you out there aren't familiar with their work. It just kind of hit me when I saw these. Like, this came from Barbara's house, and I mean, I knew that, and she made this with her own hands, and it's like. So this is envelopes, and oh my gosh, she sent me goodies inside. This is from her Felix the Fox kit. I think it was Felix's was his name. These little flags. Oh, I don't know that I'll be able to use these items at least for a while. I might need to hoard them for a bit. There's some page corners. That's so sweet of her to add some extra bits in here, because really what I paid for was the ephemera holder, but I'm not going to say no to extra pieces from her. These are so cute. I've purchased several of her digital kits in the past, and she always does a really nice job designing the shapes and everything so that when you print them, you can cut things like this, the corners, and have the little flaps and stuff. So it's, oh my gosh, it's, yeah, she's amazing. Oh, you have a tag with little flappies here. This is a postcard. I remember this too. Oh, this little bear. Oh, another postcard paper. So, Barbara, if you ever see this video, I love you. And I don't mean that in a creepy way. I mean, like, I admire your art and I admire the person that you are and how inspiring you have been. And will always be to me. That's really beautiful. I see a bingo card. Look at this. It's so pretty. Oh, yay. Yes. Okay, so I will actually use this as an ephemeral holder after I hoard it for a little while. Because it has to just stay on my special shelf for a little bit before I use it or any of the things inside. This is the package from Louisa, and it is a journal. It's a small one that she made, and again, I don't care what it is. I just want something that Louisa made. Okay, so there's a little order form here. This is a spiral-bound blank scrap junk journal, according to her shop description. Oh, look at this. So cute. I wonder if this is from her photo strips collection. Oh my gosh, Louisa made this. I mean, again, I know that. Like, same thing with Barbara's, but Louisa made this. Dear Bobby, thank you so much for your order, Louisa. this is so weird. It's amazing and also, like, scary because, like, these are my heroes. These are my junk journaling heroes that I look up to so much and adore. And, like, she actually wrote on this paper. Comment below if you can identify with my weird freaking outness. Oh. A sticker that says thanks for supporting the business. And again, I will provide links for her as well below. It's a bulb pin with a button on it. That's a cute way to like hold the lace together. Oh my heavens. I know I'm not saying much right now. I'm just trying to like soak in the fact that the last person to touch this before me was Louisa Heinzel. Like, how do I wrap my brain around that? She's tied it closed with this beautiful, beautiful lace ribbon. And there's this doily that she included. Oh my heavens. And this fabric. Did she dye this? Oh my gosh. So I'm going to talk to Louisa here for a second as well. I don't know if you'll ever see this, Louisa, but I love you too. And again, not in a weird way. Just, oh my gosh. You and Barbara started me on this journey and to hold something in my hands that you made and wrapped up and, like, I don't have the right words. This fabric is stunning. It's got to have been dyed, right? Oh my gosh. Okay. Breathe. Words. This is like, have you heard of this phenomenon called joy rising? Oprah talked about it on her show many, many, many years ago when she still had a show, and this thing where there's like so much joy you can't handle it. That's how I'm feeling right now. So, oh my gosh. Louisa Heinzel made this. We've got a coin here and a button on this bulb pin. Coin is from 1808. At least it has the date 1808 on it. Could be like a replica thing. Oh, this book is from Berlin in 1924. So I'm going to have to send a picture of this to Roger. I have a friend who lives in Berlin and he's a librarian. He would so, so appreciate this. So this is going to be very, like, grungy, scrappy from the pictures that I saw in her Etsy shop of it. And I'm totally up for that. I love this old German font. I have one book that has pages in it like this. And sometimes I'll get them out and put them into junk journals. But I'm also hoarding it a little bit because I love it so much. It's so beautiful. Paper ruffles. I can tell along the edges here we're going to have quite a few paper ruffles, which I'm excited about. I like good ruffle. Oh, we have some glassine. just died. That's got oxide on it right there. This is a card. Oh, sorry, you're out of frame. Did you even see that part? I wonder if this is a jelly plate print. Some people out there might be going, why are you so freaked out over this? It's like little scraps. It is, but they're Louisa scraps, and there's this beautiful arch to the way that she puts things together. And I love a good scrappy, grungy journal. I think they're so gorgeous. Okay, so this is vellum paper that has like some little birds printed on it. Something, and then some more clustering and some sheet music. I wouldn't have thought to do it upside down, but I quite like it. It's just another like artistic choice. Oh my gosh. You've got to see this. You've got to see this. Look at this. So she signed her name here, Louisa Heinzel, 100. This is her 100th journal. Huh? And I own it! Breathe. Oh my gosh. And this flips out and there's some kind of shiny, maybe mica spray stuff on there. So if you haven't, sorry, I moved you out of frame again. after this thing that I freaked out over, we have this. That's beautiful. If you haven't watched Louisa's channel, I highly recommend it. She used to be a teacher. I believe it's like a primary school teacher. And that comes across in her tutorials. She always explains every step and she explains what not to do and what to do and why you do them. She's an amazing teacher, and I'm a school teacher, I should know. And also, she's an amazing artist. She is a maker for Tim Holtz, so if you like Tim Holtz products, she can show you her makes for that. And it was so amazing when she got the call to become a maker, because everyone who had been with her channel knew how much she loved Tim Holtz products, and I can only imagine the joy that was coursing through her being as that happened. Look at this is a little pocket right here. Maybe it was even more than the joy that I have holding this beautiful item. Oh my goodness. These book pages, she's stenciled on some of them and added some gesso on some. What is this? Is that a print? That looks like old, like, advertisements and stuff. You can see here there's an ad for pansy seeds, forest supplies, but then there's this on top, so it's like a digital. It feels like maybe matte photo paper, maybe this. And this cluster down here at the bottom. Eco-dyed paper, look at the leaf prints. Oh my gosh. I mean, I'm freaking out over this page. Look at how simple but beautiful. Like packaging paper with some gesso and a paper cluster sewn on. And some of this paper, it looks like it's been dyed. I mean, it's beautiful. How am I ever going to use this journal? It's again, like the item from Barbara. This is going to have to be hoarded for a while. have this beautiful side pocket here. And then a little cluster down here, stenciled on book pages. I have another question for Louisa, like, or I don't know if I asked a question of her before, but also, like, if Louisa ever watches this. How does it feel being so gosh dang smart and creative? Like, seriously, I would like to know. I watch her tutorials, and I always say out loud to my iPad or my TV, wherever I'm watching it, dang it, Louisa! Because then I have to try what she's doing. For example, with the fabric tabs that she made, when I watched that tutorial, I had to immediately go make some. I got up in the middle of the night to get supplies ready and stuff to make them. Or her altered paper clips, or I don't know. Like, I would say, like, to ask, is it fun having a brain that works that way? Like, it is amazing. This is beautiful. I'm so happy. Maybe someday I'll be able to afford one of her larger journals, but for now, this is, like, literally causing me so much happiness I can't take it. That's why I'm struggling to find the words to say in this video. This looks like it's been folded up, and then, like, there's maybe some spray stains here, sewn around to make a pocket, no ruffle. This page, I don't know if it's from a children's book or something, but it says, I think this says the pig, das Schwein. Does that mean the pig? There is a little piggy right there. Some donkey, so maybe it's a book about farm animals. Oh, look at this cluster. It's just perfect. This yellow is beautiful as well. I really like that. And I'm not usually a huge fan of yellow, but it works with all of the other, like, browns and creams and stuff. This just works. Here she's turned a book page sideways. That's a good idea, just to give some variety. This little packaging stuff here, I've seen her use in other videos. This came from Louisa's house. It keeps hitting me over and over again. Oh, this is some Christmas scrapbooky paper, I think. I could feel the embossing on it. If you didn't want to do something Christmassy here, you could cover it with something else. Ooh, she swatched a ink or oxide pad here. What color do we think this is? Peacock feathers, maybe? Or maybe it's too dark for that. Uncharted Mariner? I don't know. I've seen her do that in videos so many times. It shouldn't make me emotional. This is a little tuck spot down here. And that looks like real vintage ephemera. That doesn't look like a digital print. And there's another tuck spot on the back side. And that brings us to the end. Oh my heavens. This is amazing. It is just amazing. And it's going to have to get wrapped back up again and protected. Oh, so we made it through. I didn't cry. I got close at one point. I don't know what else I can say. Thank you to those of you who continued through the video with me. I'm sorry that I was gushing the whole time. This literally is just such a joy-rising moment for me. And I hope someday that I can be as much of a positive influence on someone else as these two ladies have been on me. They've gotten me through some really hard times. some very recently, and it's not just the beautiful artwork they create, but it's the beautiful people that they are. And I just love them. So I'm out of things to say. So again, thank you for watching. Have a wonderful, magical, and bookish day. Happy reading, crafting, or journaling. Adios.